So this movie stars King freaking Kong, magical creatures, a mystical island, and freaking kaiju. It's gotta be awesome, right? Hey guys, this is Alachi, and this is my review for Kong Skull Island. This is Jordan Vaught Roberts' first time directorial debut with a major film. It is written by Dan Gilroy, Max Bornstein, and Derek Connolly, and it stars Tom Hiddleston, Brie Larson, Samuel L. Jackson, John C. Reilly, John Goodman, Tian Jing, and Toby Kebbell. It is about an expedition out into a uncharted Pacific island where there's a theory of creatures existing on this earth that we have never discovered. Okay, so like I said before, it features King Kong and a whole host of other really crazy stuff. An incredibly fascinating, mysterious island. And a fuck ton of explosions, and I don't know how they did it, but it is boring as fuck. It is so boring. So freaking boring. And this might be a tribute to the fact that once you've seen a lot of films, once you have seen a lot of films in the 90s, a lot of films in the 2000s, you can kind of understand that there has developed a formula over time about how you set up characters, especially characters that you plan to kill off later in the film, as well as giving people kind of superficial reasons for being there, mainly your superstars and your actors. And then the idea of wanting to set up a magnificent money shot, but not really having a really good plot to get you there. But all you know is that you want to build up to this shot, that you want to build up to this moment, and you don't really care how you get there. So you just sort of throw the most generic plots that you can just borrow from every other film that's ever been out there, and you just stick it in the movie, and that's pretty much what they did. I mean, I can't even recommend this for watching on Netflix later or streaming or even renting. The only thing I can actually say is watch, maybe rent it to fast forward to that money shot, right? The build up, you know, the scene that everyone's sort of expecting, you know, because it's King Kong, right? You kind of know that there's an end money shot, and that money shot is good. It's good. It's visual effects. I have like pretty much two pros for this movie. The visual effects are really good. The CGI work is really good. It was kind of nice to see the visualization. But we've kind of seen this before, and it's not like, you know, this is nothing new. And then the creatures that they sort of developed, I kind of liked that world that they created. I liked Skull Island. You know, I liked being there in a way, but the people and the characters that they sort of set up to be on there were so unrealistic, so generic, and I couldn't have cared less about what they were trying to do, why they were there. They were just simply fodder so that they could develop this story where they could have King Kong, you know, do his thing at the end. I'm not going to say what he does, but you can kind of guess that he's going to do something big. All of the characters are terrible in this movie. Every single one. Samuel L. Jackson tries to give his best version of Apocalypse Now, but it comes off super cheesy and silly, and I think that the whole movie is really silly. You know, John C. Reilly's character is sort of introduced at the very beginning of the movie, which I thought the opening sequence and the scene was really good. I was sort of like, wow, this is okay, I'm gonna buy this, and then it just sort of cuts to the present time, which is 1973, and then after that, I'm sitting in my chair just going like, oh my god, this is so dull, I don't care, don't care. Oh, this is going to happen. Yep, that happened. Oh, I bet this is going to happen next. Yeah, that happened next. And normally I don't care if they sort of do that. If in the moment they build it up so that the tension is good, that they bring me into a sense of heightened state of kind of like expectation, but it didn't. So when you look at, when you think about things like movies like Jurassic Park, there is this sense of tension that's built, right? Especially when you're talking about monsters. You want to set up a sense of scale and a sense of tension to that moment where you are revealed to this, you know, this out of this world, extraordinary, beyond real creature. And they don't do that. It's just, I never get that sense of scale where I'm like, oh my God, he's fucking huge. Like, look at this poster, okay? I will just insert the poster in the video. But you can see how large he looks in this poster compared to the helicopter. That is not how it is in the movie. In the movie, Kong just never feels all that huge, actually. And nothing feels grand on or any large scale. It just feels like I'm watching a really good generic monster movie. That's it, you know, a Kong movie. There was absolutely no tension building, no teasing of Kong. They just sort of spoon feed you him. They sort of spoon feed you everything. And so, like, I just felt like everything was meh. Everything was meh. And you think with Kong, you're like, come on, man, like there should be something there. You know, like, I didn't think the plot of Godzilla was interesting at all, but, you know, how they sort of led up to Godzilla was good. Same thing with Pacific Rim, you know, the plot was so stupid. But the way that they're able to convey, like, this epic grand scale of these things that are supposed to, like, fight each other, and you're supposed to be impressed by those moments, this movie never gave that to me. And so, and then of course, you know, like I said, the plot itself is super generic, super silly, super ridiculous. Nothing made sense. Tons of plot holes, tons of plot devices just to get you from one scene to the next that made absolutely no sense, which I'll discuss in the spoiler section. But yeah, I was really disappointed in this. And I even went in with low expectations so that I would hopefully come out sort of having enjoyed the movie a little bit more. But even with low expectations. So I'm going to give Kong Skull Island a D+. And that's mainly because the visual effects were there, but nothing else was. All right, so let's get into spoilers. So the year is 1944, and two planes drop out of the sky, one with an American soldier and one with a Japanese soldier. And they're rumbling on this mystical island that they have fallen into, and until one of them is about to kill the other, and then King Kong shows up, and then the scene cuts. Cut to John Goodman, who is trying to fill up a team to lead an expedition out into this uncharted Pacific island, where he has this theory that mystical creatures are alive and well on Earth and have always existed, and he's going to prove it. So he fills up this team full of people he needs, like a tracker, a photographer, he needs a military escort, basically fodder, you know, for later on when they have to go up against monsters. They get to the island, and I sort of think that they're going to explore the island and then things are going to happen. No, like right away, they start to throw these bombs down into the island so that they can, they think that they're doing it for seismic sort of geographical research, but John Goodman knows that he's doing it to lure out whatever creature is in the island. And bam, Kong's there immediately. Like, the first thing you get to the island, and immediately King Kong is sort of established as the enemy. And then Samuel Jackson sort of gets it up his ass that he has to kill Kong. And that becomes the entire plot of the movie, is Samuel Jackson is out to basically kill King Kong because he swiped out a bunch of helicopters that were trying to bomb this island. The other part of it is, of course, most of the team actually wants to escape off the island and get back to home. But along the way, they actually run into one of the American soldiers that had fallen out of the sky in 1944, which is John C. Reilly, and his character's absolutely ridiculous. Just so ridiculous. He's been shacking up with these Aborigines for 20 plus years, and he doesn't even... there's like no communication between them. I don't even know why they're there. They do nothing with these characters. They do nothing with this village of people. They have created this gate, this giant wall to keep the kaiju out and all these other creatures from killing them. And I'm like, how are a bunch of sticks supposed to keep this kaiju out? But somehow it does. Maybe it has magical powers. I don't really know. They somehow make a boat to sort of sail down the river to get to a point where they're all trying to get so they can get off the island. And the gate that the gate they had built on the water actually has this gate system, this actual door that opens up. And I'm like, you don't have boats. Why would you even have created this? It made no sense. And then later on, there's like toxic gas bombs that they sort of explode into the area. And everyone's just breathing normally. Like, it's toxic gas. Tom Hiddleston picks up a gas mask and he just barely puts it on to go grab some guy. But he, like, everyone else is in the middle of it. And it's just, the reason I think they did that is because they wanted to save some money on those shots. So they wanted just green gas in the background. But they were also in a killing field that was obviously this feeding ground for the kaiju. And the whole team's like, yeah, let's go ahead and just go through this thing. And that's a really smart idea, I think, you know. Meanwhile, you have Brie Larson, who's only purpose on the team is to take photographs of everything. And somehow she's able to take photographs in low light to no light, no problem, you know, being tossed from a helicopter, no problem. I can get the shot. Sometimes she just takes shots of things. She just stands up next to them and takes a shot. And I'm like, how much film did you bring? This is an old 1973 camera. But the whole point of her actually being there is because they needed a pretty blonde girl to connect with King Kong, right? Because that's the trope. But other than that, there's really no point for her to be there. And she just makes these really silly faces. They do a close-up and she makes a very constipated look. Tom Hiddleston, he's there as their tracker. And yet, he's the worst tracker ever. He's the worst guide to go on this island with. The only thing he ever does is just goes like, yeah, it's 10 clicks east that way. That's it. I'm just like, you might want to tell them to be careful because a lot of things might kill them here. Maybe some survival tricks. Nope, none of that. He's just the handsome white lead. That's it. And speaking of people that are just there, Tian Jing, but she's only there so that this film debuts in every single Chinese theater when it comes out. So it's just sort of like there was a contract in there. It was like, yeah, by the way, we're going to have this Chinese character come into your movie. We don't really care what you do with her. Just make sure she lives to the end. That's it. I'm like, okay, because she pretty much did absolutely nothing. She gives a couple of one-liners and that's pretty much it. There's just so much potential with this, with the base of the story. And I guess the fact that they had three different screenwriters on here is probably a good indication that they really didn't have real direction in terms of where they wanted to take it, and no real vision. Or maybe you don't really understand, you never know in these types of productions, like how things actually unfold in terms of how the story ends up being developed with the screenplay writers and who originally wrote the script, who rewrote the script, etc. Good news for anybody who really likes this movie, Max Bornstein, who was on the screenplay, his credited for the screenplay as well, is going to be doing the next Godzilla and the next Godzilla versus King Kong movie, which I'm sort of like, bummer, because I don't know, maybe hopefully they'll get someone else who can direct it a little bit better. But it's just, there's sort of like a heart of darkness that they could have like, a theme that they could have attached to this. They could have given you a story where you actually understood, like maybe came in like having one vision of King Kong coming out with another. Instead, John C. Reilly expositions the whole thing for you. You don't get to sort of fall in love with King Kong. He just tells you that you need to be in love with King Kong. He tells you the importance through exposition, why King Kong is important, how he's a good guy, and that you should root for him. And that's it. And then, of course, they set up the kaiju against King Kong, and that's the ending money shot, which is, it's good. I liked it. It was fun to watch that part, but everything else was just sort of like, well, I just could have done without it. This is really disappointing. And I didn't even go in with high expectations, so I don't know why I was so disappointed. I guess I wanted it to defy my expectations. And when I see fantasy ideas like this, I think I see a lot of potential, and I'm just like, there's a lot of creativity that can come out of this. But when you just overlay a generic plot, generic characters, it's always really sad. And again, it may just be my age, right? Just maybe because I've seen so many of these sort of monster films and you know, go out and have an objective, create a team type movies that I've seen it done so many times before. So when it's kind of like thrown on another platter for me to like eat, I'm like, I've already had this like 30 times. I think I was just sort of hoping that they would do King Kong a little different, a little bit unique, something much more exciting, a lot larger scale, something more thrilling, you know, like something that gave me some sort of tangible, visceral experience where I was like really in awe. And I think a lot of times I'm still trying to recapture that moment I had when, you know, the freaking brontosaurus shows up in Jurassic World. And you think that a film like this could bring me something like that. But it never had a moment that was even close to that. All right, guys, let me know what you guys thought about Kong Skull Island if you've seen it, and what you think about the upcoming Godzilla versus King Kong film. All right, thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side.